The fear of the Lord saves us from sin. We've been talking about the heart attitude of the fear of God, which essentially means reverence and awe towards God. And this attitude will help us to stay away from sin. Now, when we look at people in the Bible, we see that anyone who feared God, anyone who honored God, you know, automatically kept themselves away from wrongdoing. And there are many examples of this, but I'm going to talk about two examples. One is Nehemiah. Now, Nehemiah was working with a large number of people, and Nehemiah was in a place where he could set his own standards. You know, as an employer, he could set his own, he was not an employer, but you know, a position of authority actually, but he could set his rules and laws as people worked for him and with him. And even today, you know, we can set our own standards. But what is different about Nehemiah? We read that Nehemiah feared God, and so he did not put additional burden on the people. This is in Nehemiah 5:15. But the former governors who were before me laid burdens on the people and took from them bread and wine, besides 40 shekels of silver. Yes, even their servants bore rule over the people, but I did not do so because of the fear of God. So Nehemiah was a different leader. He did not lord over the people. He did not treat the people like slaves, like the other governors, but he treated them well. He was someone who set a high standard. He set a different standard. And why was he able to do this? Because his attitude in his relationship toward God was the fear of God. Nobody was watching him. The people didn't ask him to do that. There were no other, his peers who wanted him to do things like this. But the fear of the Lord caused him to make such decisions which are different, which are the best. Now, let's look for a moment at the life of Joseph. You know, Joseph went through many trials in his life, and he also went through temptation, the time when Potiphar's wife tempted him. But in those moments, we can understand the relationship that Joseph had with God. You know, the time when Joseph said that, I'm not going to sin by laying with my master's wife. But notice he very emphatically says that he doesn't get into the sin, not because he wants to be righteous only for the sake of his boss, who is Potiphar, who's away. But he makes a statement where he says it's sin against God, and I'll read it for us. Genesis 39:9. There is no one greater in this house than I, nor has he kept back anything from me but you, because you are his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God? So Joseph didn't sin as he was thinking about his relationship with God in the midst of temptation. And even today, if we think about our relationship with God all the time, I'm sure it'll keep us from a lot of harm. It'll keep us from getting into sin and getting entangled in sin. Let's pray, and let's ask the Holy Spirit to strengthen us to live a life that is of the fear of the Lord. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for these examples of people who stayed away from sin by walking in the fear of God. Lord, they thought of you before they did anything, Father God. And so, God, today, as we go about our lives, Father, we pray that, Lord, you will be the center, O God, that, Lord, fearing you, honoring you will be our primary focus. And God, even as we do that, Lord, we thank you that we will walk a straight path, Lord. Father, that you are going to establish, Father God, our path. Father, we give you glory, Lord, for leading us in this way. We honor you and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.